One of the most fun aspects of Blood Bowl is customising your own team, and especially if you're looking to play as one of the teams inside the Death Zone book, you'll know that not all these actually have models yet, in which case you have to convert an entire team of miniatures. Now in this video we're going to give you a great idea of how to go about doing that for the Nurgle team. And to do this, what you need to do is just look through the Citadel range and pick out miniatures you think will work really well for the various players. Now in this video we're going to show you how to make a bloater, and the obvious choice for this is a putrid Blight King. But it's also a good idea with Nurgle because, well, you've got a real advantage here, to get hold of a box of zombies as well, because not only do these give you all the rotters you're ever going to need for your team, but also you get lots of spare open hands as well. And well, with Blood Bowl miniatures, when you're converting them, what you want to do is look to take away all the weapons from normal Warhammer miniatures to make them look more like players. And with all these spare hands from the zombie kit, you'll have loads of open hands to do just this. And we're going to use one of these in this as well. I've got all my parts for my Blight King, but also I've got this hand here, which is from the zombie set. Perfect open hand we're going to use later on. Now also, I've got a ball here, which is a spare from the orc frame in the main box game. We're going to use that later on, have the player holding it to make him look a bit more Blood Bowl. And this one, well, this is to go inside the base, which you'll see later on when we get to that part. Now what we need to do is just start building the model as normal, but start looking at it as we go along to see how we can make it more Blood Bowl. Now to begin with, we're going to start with the main parts of the body, and I'm just going to build the kit as normal. And I'm going to stick the parts together with plastic glue, beginning with the two parts of the body here, and then I'm going to assemble the legs as well. And there we are, the body's fully built, and we're now ready to glue it to a base. Now with Blood Bowl, what you need is a 32mm round base for each one of your players. And I've got one here, and you might want to add a hole to it to hold the ball, just like the ones you get inside the main set. Now to do this, I'm using my Citadel drill, and I'm using the largest drill bit that you get in the set. And what you do is just pick a point close to the front of the base, about there will do, and then all you got to do is start drawing that hole directly down into the base. There, like that. So just be careful to make sure it pops through. And there we go. Right, now, this drill bit needs to be a little bit wider, really, for the ball to fit in. So what I'm going to do is place it through the hole and just gently widen it out by just rotating the drill like this, gradually widening the hole as I go. And periodically, all you need to do is just stop and just check the ball fitting through. So that's what we've got this one here for. All I'm going to do is just check that the hole's wide enough and a little bit wider, I think. There we go. And check again. And there we go. Right, sorted. So now that done, we're now ready to glue the miniature to the base. The miniature is now glued securely to the base, and we're ready to start adding in the arms. And here we're going to start doing a little bit of converting, because I've picked out this claw arm for the right arm. This one's perfect because it's so open, perfect for nesting the ball just there in the crook of the arm. So my plan is to glue the ball in there like that. Now when you're doing a conversion like this with parts that aren't designed to go together this way, it's important that you do a dry fit first of all, just to make sure everything fits. And you can see there's a boil just there, which is preventing the ball from nestling securely in the arm. So what I need to do before I glue anything is remove that. Now you could do this with a hobby knife if you wanted to, but if you're a youngster, be sure to get an adult to do it for you. Alternatively, what you can do is use some files, which is what I'm going to do now, and then I'm going to glue in the ball. I've carried on building the miniature, and now there's only one part left to attach, and that's the left hand. Now remember, we're going to use some spare zombie parts for this. I've got the zombie's arm here, and what we need to do is remove the hand from the rest of the zombie's arm. So to do this, I'm just going to use my clippers and just cut it just down here, smooth down the joint with a file, and then glue it on. And here we have our completed bloater, ready to be undercoated and painted. And, well, as you can see, doing this is lots of fun, but the real key to it is just planning out what you want to do before you start getting hold of the kits and cutting the parts out. But I really do recommend you give it a go, because if you do, you're going to get a team that's completely unique and will stand out amongst all of your friends. So I really hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you all again soon.